Hi, I'm Marty Pfeiffer, a TA at College of the Canyons. I'm going to walk you through how to put different materials on objects in Adobe Photoshop. I developed this method after learning more about blending modes and what they can be useful for. I'll show you how to do it. First, you have to mask the area you want to have new material applied to. Then you neutralize the colors of the masked area so that the blend will be most effective. And the easiest step is last. Try on a new material by using a pattern layer. So let's get started. To tell Photoshop which area you want to replace with a different material, you'll create a mask. This is a fundamental first step to lots of other actions in Photoshop, so you probably have your own preferred method. That's cool. Use whatever works for you. If you're old school like me, I'll first duplicate the layer, make the selection, and then click the mask button in the layers panel. The new way to mask can be a bit easier to get great results without fiddling around. First, you make a rough selection. Then you select Select and Mask in the options bar. From there, a panel will appear on the right side that will let you refine your selection. Depending on your object, it's helpful to change the view mode to either on white or on black. I always preview my mask by selecting black and white before pressing OK on the panel. You can go in with the brush tool and manually fix any areas that Photoshop got wrong. Once you are done refining your selection, you make sure the output settings are set to New Layer with Layer Mask, and then hit OK. So I've already made a rough selection here, so I'm just going to hit Select and Mask and clean things up a bit. So I'm using some of the Photoshop features like changing the radius and adding Smart Radius. It just kind of helps clean up the edges sometimes. Makes your job easier. And then this is what I was talking about on black and on white. Gives you a better idea of what the final image is going to look like. One thing I noticed here was that the tag was not masked when I did my rough selection. So I'm having to deselect that so that it gets masked. I'll just kind of clean that up a bit. The view mode for black and white. This is actually showing you what the mask is. So this is when you create a new layer with a layer mask, this is what that mask is going to look like. So you can go through and anything that you want to see should be white. So I know most of the shirt needs to be white. So the edges around there that aren't white, I can just go in and kind of clean those up a bit manually. So I'll do that with the buttons here too. So that the buttons are all just round. To just clean up anything that I see that's kind of just some noise or whatever. It's very satisfying, which is good because a lot of your time in Photoshop is spent refining masks. So it's nice that this can be a fun process. And, you know, Photoshop is, you know, famous for, you know, doing so many things, but you have to do a mask first. So this is just part of the process. And there we go. We're going to output to a new layer with layer mask. And then there it is. Bam. Neutralizing color allows us to simplify getting new material onto the subject. Since we're using a blending mode to put the new material onto the old, we only want to deal with changes of light and dark. We want this layer to be a neutral gray before we try to put anything on top of it. Hue and saturation will only distract us. With the new layer selected, add a black and white adjustment layer to it and then clip it, so that it affects the area you've just masked out. To clip the layer to the one below it, just hit the Alt key on Windows or Option key on the Mac and click the area between the layers. Next, add a curves adjustment layer and clip it to the layer below. You can quickly adjust the curve by selecting the finger tool, making sure the sample size is set to anything other than point sample, and then clicking and holding over any area of the image that represents the midpoint. We want to adjust this so that the midpoint is about 50% gray in the histogram. So you can watch that as you move the finger up and down until it gets to the center horizontal line. And I'll show you that right now. So I'll turn the background layer on so you can see we still have a background here as well, and tags. Now I'm adding that black and white adjustment layer. That's really all I need to do other than clip it. And we're adding a curves adjustment layer, and we're clipping that one as well. That's the little finger tool that I was talking about. This is actually kind of a new one for me. I'm not sure that it's been in Photoshop for very long, but it's kind of fun. You can actually adjust the curves by selecting a color in the image rather than clicking into the histogram. So you see that black dot is now on the center line there. So I've moved that up. Everything's been bumped up a bit. So I guess the image was a little dark before. Sometimes you have to make it lighter to get to that neutral gray. Now here's the fun part. To put a new material onto the object we've just masked and neutralized, just add it on a layer above the curves layer we created earlier. You'll need to clip it to the layer below. Then change the blending mode to overlay. So here we're back and we're going to put a pattern layer above our curves adjustment. And I'm going to change that to, let's try trees. And we'll play with the scale a bit to get it to make a little more sense on our image. Okay, and of course we have to clip it, and we kind of have something that looks like a pattern going onto fabric, but when we change it to overlay mode, everything just comes together. And just to show you that this isn't just a fluke, let's change the pattern to something else, something totally different, water. I'll change the scale here as well. Increase that a bit. Now that looks like something you would buy. That's pretty awesome. So now you're probably wondering, why does it work? I'll explain. Overlay takes whatever color is in the blend layer, that's the layer with the new material, and creates a new color that shows the influence of the base layer. That's why you can put a red blend on top of a cyan and end up with a nice blue. This isn't exactly helpful for trying to get the actual color of the pattern imposed onto an existing object though, so we must do a bit more. To make color alterations more predictable, we want to change the base layer to shades of gray. One of the side effects of the overlay blend mode is that at 50% gray, the base layer passes through unchanged. So that's why we want to use curves to adjust our base layer to emphasize this level of gray. On the other hand, lighter shades of gray in the base layer will lighten colors in the blend layer. And of course, darker shades will darken. But what about black and white? When these colors exist in the original image, they indicate either that there is no light reflected off the image, that is black, or that all light is reflected off the image, creating a specular highlight, in other words, white. To look real, we need to preserve these features from the original image. Of the different modes, multiply will keep blacks, and screen will keep whites. Overlay will keep them both. Therefore, it is the best blending mode for this approach. I hope this helps you apply different materials to your graphics in Photoshop. Thanks for watching.